Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Donkey Kong Country Returns playthrough. In our last episode, we continued World 2, the beach, with 2-3, 2-4, and 2-5. We now have only two levels left to go before the boss stage, and if everything goes well, we might just be able to finish off World 2 in this video. So, our next level in line is 2-6, Blowhole Bound. Let's go ahead and get started. And these next two levels, I'm telling you right now, are going to be a real doozy to complete. But DK is ready for the challenge, and we must be ready for the challenge as well, especially me, because I'm the one actually playing the game here. And both levels that we have to complete will be interesting experiences, to say the least. That is for certain. Anyway, in this first part of the stage, use your hand slap here, and then use the barrel cannon to go into our bonus stage, which is going to be a platforming type bonus stage, so this shouldn't be too strenuous, shouldn't be too taxing, you know? It's not like a bonus stage with the barrels, where you really need to be on your toes. But of course, we do have a timer, so we can't screw around entirely. We do need to be quick. And there is our first puzzle piece of the stage. 1 out of 5, a pretty good start. And before you advance, watch yourself. I've had many times where I'll immediately try to run forward, and that squid cannon will catch me off guard. It will catch you off guard too if you're not careful. And here's our main gimmick of the stage. Break that anchor and this whale will break free, and this is the blowhole in Blowhole Bound. We're going to be spending the entire remainder of this stage, or almost the entirety of it, on this whale's back, and we do need to keep up with it. So, we're going for a ride. You will occasionally have platform sections, like the one we just passed, that, once again, you're going to have to move quickly because you cannot afford to fall behind the whale. Also, you have the screen scrolling with the whale, so this is essentially an auto-scrolling stage. So, don't dilly-dally. And we've got the electric squid, too. Pretty easy to avoid if you pay attention to where they're coming from. Luckily, there is a brief reprieve from the whale. We do have a section where we're on dry land, and still something pretty cool here. We have these seagulls that look like bowling pins. And what do you know? You can roll into them like bowling pins, too. So, anyone up for some bowling? To quote my old Spyro the Dragon Let's Play. And when I say my old one, I mean my first one from 2009. But this is not Spyro, this is Donkey Kong Country. And I'll take that extra life. Nothing to complain about there. Complaining wouldn't do me much good at all. So here we go with our next whale area. Use the squids right there to springboard up to the puzzle piece right there. Now, bouncing off of enemies does not work like it does in, say, the 2D Mario games. This is actually something that I feel the need to touch on. You can do what I call the Badnik bounce, you know, bouncing off of enemies for springboards and stuff, but the way it works is a little weird if you're used to how it works in the Mario games. In the Mario games, you can just bounce off of them, and I believe all you have to do is really just hold the jump button when you land on them. Here, holding the jump button is not enough. You have to actually tap the jump button again right as you land on the enemy so that it'll work, basically. And see, we're not gonna get that puzzle piece, unfortunately, because I did not pull off the Badnik bounce correctly. But I did pull it off for the Kong letter. So we're gonna have to backtrack, of course, for the puzzle pieces, but we did make it through the level in one piece. And we did manage to get all the Kong letters, so that's 2-6. Blowhole Bound is done. And that leaves one level to go before the boss. But it's a level that could be a major roadblock. Luckily, we do open a path straight to Stormy Shore. It's really weird how this is set up. Like, if you beat Peaceful Pier, you unlock the path to Blowhole Bound and Cannon Cluster, but not Stormy Shore. It's kind of weird how 2-6 and 2-5 are arranged, but minor complaint, if you can call it one, and now we've got one level left, and it's one that could really hamper our chances at progressing. 2-7, Tidal Terror. So that remark I just made about this level hampering our progress, yeah, it's living up to that. So yes, this part of the video is a separate recording from the earlier portion, because I actually had to restart because this level is giving me problems. So let's see if we can get a successful recording of 2-7 Tidal Terror. This is a level that certainly lives up to its name in both parts. It's tidal and it's filled with terror. This may be the first part of the playthrough where there's actually going to be genuine rage on the video. I try to avoid really bad rage in my videos, but sometimes it's just unavoidable, and this level may be what triggers it. I hate this level. This has been a major roadblock for me in all the times I've gone through World 2 in this game. And the gimmick is pretty obvious. We've got, well, it's a dark and stormy night, obviously, and we've got basically the storm surge from the storm is coming in, and it is basically taking out everything. And when the wave splashes over the level, you need to be behind something, like these walls and stuff. If you are not behind something when the wave crashes into the level, that is it. You're dead. The wave will kill you instantly. It does not matter how much health you have. It doesn't matter if you have both Kongs or one Kong. You take a hit from the wave, you're dead. No questions asked. Now, sometimes you'll come across those red buttons, and if you pound the red buttons, a temporary wall will pop up. Use that to your advantage. However, the wall does not stay up forever. So when you do your hand slap, you need to time it so that the wall is up when the tidal wave comes in. Or tsunami, I guess it should be called. They don't really call them tidal waves anymore. But anyway, we can get a puzzle piece by pounding those pillars and drop down into here and you'll have our bonus game. I believe this is the first time we've encountered this particular bonus. Basically, you have a cluster of barrel cannons and you need to use all these barrel cannons in different configurations in order to get all the items. And now, let's see if we can get the puzzle piece. Yes, indeed! Alright, we've made it this far. Like, seriously, I despise this stage. I mean, especially the parts where there are long portions where there's no wall protecting you, so you need to hoof it, or else you're not gonna make it. Luckily, we approached the checkpoint, so we have that going for us, and we do have these portions right here where we're inside caves and stuff, so the level designers were... I let go of the one button too soon. There's no point in me getting mad over that. I let my thumb just the slightest bit off the one button, and look what happened. Luckily, we didn't lose that much progress. It sucks that we lost Diddy Kong, but what are you gonna do? There's the inn. Let me guess. I gotta do that trick. So like I was trying to say, the level designers were kind enough to give us places where we don't have to worry about the tide coming in all the time. We do have some brief respites from, you know, being washed out. But again, you do not want to be caught in the tidal wave when it comes in. And another note to make, Mercy Invincibility will not protect you from the wave. If you get hit by an enemy and like you're flashing from the Mercy Invincibility, you will not be protected. Let me lay that down right now. You will not be protected by Mercy Invincibility from an enemy. Even that will not save you. Now, when you're in this area with the broken pirate ship, watch out for the windows, because the water does come crashing through the windows, and that torrent of water will also kill you. So, I mean, this level is really, really nasty, but we were able to get through it. Finally, a successful run. Man, whew. I mean, seriously, I had to cut the video a few times and give this a few attempts, but we are able to clear it. There was definitely some failure mixed in, though. I can't believe I just dropped off the vines like that. You know, the moss that you're supposed to cling to. Cannot believe I just dropped off like that, but I must have taken my thumb just the slightest bit off the one button, and it counted as, you know, me letting go. Anyway, we finally managed to unlock the secret level for World 2, but much like World 1, we're going to be saving the secret levels for later. For now, we are just one level away from being done with World 2. It's time for the boss, Pinchin' Pirates. Off we go! Let's see if we can finish off this world and move on to the next one. Now, much like the first boss level, we don't have any Kong letters or puzzle pieces to worry about. Let's go straight to the point. And away we go with this boss fight, and this is actually going to be my third attempt, because I'm surprisingly having trouble with this fight. This boss fight is actually not really that difficult, but it does have a bit of a trick to it. Basically, you've got three pirate crabs, the Pinchin' Pirates in the title of the level, and basically you need to jump on them. And when you jump on them, they will raise their pincers, and from there, you need to flip them and then jump on their undersides. Very much like the red crab enemies from the regular levels. Now, when they get to this phase, you'll need to wait for them to raise their pincers and then roll into them. And then from there, quickly jump on all three of them, and you will begin the next phase of the fight. Now the thing is, when the crabs are moving around by themselves, they'll also raise their pincers in an effort to prevent you from jumping on them in the first place. All three have different rhythms and patterns and timing, so you need to be on your guard. Don't try to rush this fight. Try to take your time and wait for your opening. Like... come on. Oh, he got me! But he won't get me this time. And gotcha! Wait for it, wait for it. Dang it! And there goes Diddy. I probably shouldn't have cornered myself like that. So we gotta do this all with one Kong. And I was not able to do it. Yes, if you take too long, you will not be able to take them all out. Gotcha! And that's it! Believe me, it's a lot simpler than I made it look. Look at the tikis in the background! I just now noticed this. The tikis are like, what? They lost? Bye-bye! Oh my goodness. ...22 hits? And that is it for the beach. Man, this recording's been rough. Had a hard time with 2-7. The boss fight gave me a hard time for some reason. I really could have played that a lot better, but we still managed to get through it, and we have unlocked World 3? The Ruins. However, if you want to see what the ruins are like, you're going to have to wait until the next episode, because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Donkey Kong Country Returns playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode. Thank you.